Hi, I'm Daniel Rogge. Today we're going to talk about loading tools and removing tools using your Tormach ATC. So here I've got PathPilot screens open here, and I've tabbed over to the ATC screen. And for the purposes of this video, I'm going to assume you've already gone through the mechanical installation of the ATC and the alignment of the ATC. And we're just going to talk about using Tormach tooling with that ATC to deal with tool changing. So first off, we see an image of the tray here. These are the different pockets that are available. There are 10. It's a 770 here that we're looking at. There are actually two ways to load tools into the tray. We'll talk about both of them today. There's a manual way. It's a little faster, but a little bit more laborious. And then there's an automatic way. So we'll go over the automatic way first. I've got a tool here. We'll call it tool one. So what I'm going to do is just put it in the spindle. And anytime you put a tool in the spindle of the machine, you want to let it know that it's in the spindle. So here I am in the tool DRO. I'm going to type tool one and hit enter. All right. And then I'm just going to go store current tool. I can use that method to load the rest of the tools that I'm going to use for this job into the tray. So here's tool four, I'll call it. Go ahead and put it in the spindle. Make sure that the system knows it's tool four. And then store current tool. So now you can see we've got tools one and four in the ATC, tools one and four there in the machine. And you can use any tool you want into any pocket. So the system does not think of pockets one through 10. It's really just tools. If there's an open spot, it'll put it away. So we could call this tool 200 if we want. And we could go ahead and store tool 200. So we've got tools 1, 4, and 200 loaded in here now. If I ran a G-code program that called up a tool change for tool 1, it would fetch the tool automatically. If I want to fetch the tool manually, I could go down here and just type tool 1, M6G43. It knows that it's in the ATC, so it asks me, do I want to use the ATC to fetch the tool? So we've got tools 1, 4, and 200 in here, and maybe we're done with the job. Maybe we want to remove them. That's easy enough. We can go ahead and type the tool number in here, click remove. And we'll go ahead and grab the tool, and just wants me to remove it from the spindle here. And then that tool is not assigned to the ATC anymore. Another way that we could remove tools too, if we wanted to, we could go ahead and grab the tool this way, say tool four. We want to use it to fetch, sure. Is the spindle open? Yes, it's empty. So here we are, we'll grab tool four. And I could just go ahead and say, we're going to remove this tool. I'm going to type tool zero in there. I'll go ahead and remove it first. Type tool zero means empty spindle. I could click M6G43, say ATC restore tool. No, I don't. I'm not putting it back in there. I could have tool four already out. I could go up here, type in four, and click remove. And that'll take tool four out of the tray assignment. So let's go ahead and last thing we'll do is remove tool 200. I can either type 200 up here and then click remove. If I wanted to, I could actually click tray forward, and that'll bring whatever's at that 3 o'clock position, the spindle position. That'll pre-populate this DRO with that number, makes it a little bit easier. And so here I am, I'm just going to go ahead and remove the tool. So that's kind of the automatic way to add tools to the ATC. Really all you have to do is put the tool in the spindle, type the tool number in the tool DRO, and hit store current tool, and that'll put that tool away in any open spot in the carousel. Likewise, to remove it, you just type the tool number in here that you want to remove, click the remove button, and it'll remove the tool. But I did mention earlier that there's a slightly faster manual way to do this. So I'm going to walk you through that now. That's over on this side. This is kind of the manual insert side. I'm going to click go to tray load position. And I'll grab a couple tools here. It kind of goes without saying, you don't want to go ahead and grab the sharp end mill. So typically when I'm doing this, I'm making sure my fingers are nowhere near it. But I will go ahead and put it in there and just slide it on in. So then over here, I would just type in the tool number. Let's say this is tool 2, and hit enter a couple of times, and now tool's in that spot. Tool 2 is in that spot. I tray forward, and I can do my next tool. We'll call it tool 3, and tray forward. Tool 4. So you can see this is a slightly faster way, but a little bit more manual way of loading tools up into the tray. Otherwise, once you've got them in, once they're assigned like this, an M6 command from a G-code program or the M6 button down here will fetch any one of those tools. So if I want tool 3, type tool 3, hit enter, use the ATC to fetch the tool, yes, and it'll go grab that tool. Just as we were able to insert these tools in that manual method with the go to tray load position button, we can use that same method to delete tools from the tray. So I'll click go to tray load position. And what I can do now is just pull these tools out one by one. And then I can go ahead and just delete all of them. So that's two ways of loading tools up into your Tormach automatic tool changer. One using the tool DRO and the M6G43 button and the store current tool and remove buttons. The other way, going to tray load position and then manually putting the tools into the forks and using the insert DRO, the insert button, or the delete and delete all buttons to remove tools. For more metalworking tips and tricks, check out our other videos here, or to subscribe to our YouTube channel, click the link here. Thank you very much.